Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I just wanted to make a quick video. Don't have my backlight or whatever, my other light bulb on here, so you can still see me. Hey, listen, brothers and sisters, I've been getting lots of dreams and visions from the Lord, even dreams from the Lord for other people. Specifically, people were in my dreams, and several different ones been coming to pass. So, praise God. And the fact that it's a sign of the times, brothers and sisters, it's a sign of the end times, that we're all being able to hear more clearly and distinctly from our Lord, you know, into that day of perfection when we're out of here, brothers and sisters. Praise God for that. But let's don't praise God for the tribulation. Let's don't praise God for, you know, destruction and things like that, brothers and sisters. I want to say that. We don't delight in these things. Some people do, and that's wrong. As the Lord told John and James, he called, you know, called them sons of thunder. And they didn't know what spirit they were speaking from when they wanted to see some Samaritans destroyed because they didn't accept the Lord. They didn't receive the Lord. Anyway, you know, there's something in the military the Lord had spoke to me about the other day, brothers and sisters. I've been meaning to mention it in a video. And I'm going to give a prophecy that the Lord had given me, and I want to share it with you right now in a second. But I heard the word from the Lord, stand to. Now, those of you who are in the military, like in the Army or maybe even the Marines who are been in a war zone, you know what it is. Now, when I was not in, you know, I was in the Army for 9 years and 9 months. And when the only time we practiced stand to was during the war when I was over there in Iraq and Kuwait and all those areas, we practiced stand to. And what we did it, we didn't practice it, we did it. Stand to is something that you do in the Army, and I was even trying to look it up. It's hard to even find a reference on it. But what stand to is 30 minutes before first light, like at twilight, and then 30 minutes before dark. What you do is if you're in a, say you're in an area and then you have foxholes and all that, people will go to their perimeter, and then the people who say who are drivers of vehicles, they will all start their vehicles at an exact time, like say in the morning, it's like 5 o'clock in the morning or whatever, twilight, depends on the time of year. You will all start your vehicles synchronized at that time, 5 o'clock in the morning as an example. And then the other people who are not drivers will be in the foxhole or whatever. They will be in their battle stations, whatever you want to call it, wherever they would be at that moment. Because throughout history, brothers and sisters, almost every major battle and attack, like Pearl Harbor as an example, they always happen just at either dawn or dusk. You know, and so that's why 30 minutes prior to dawn or 30 minutes prior to dark, you know, the sun sets. And then it doesn't get dusk until the earth is actually 6 degrees below the horizon. So in the morning and the evening, I've been talking to one brother about this, and I should have made a video a long time ago about this a couple weeks ago. The Lord's been showing me. But anyway, when the sun is 6 degrees below the horizon, either rising or setting, you have this period of a little bit of light. And so in the nighttime, we call this twilight. And in the evening time, some people might call it, it's also twilight. But you have just this, the heavenly shades of night, like that song. It's actually from the Bible, the heavenly shades of night. And what they would do actually in biblical times is that they would hide in these rock cliffs. And when that's why they call them heavenly shades of night or falling. It's twilight time, like that song. What would happen is and I gave a word to somebody with that expression, and I it's not in this text. I gave a word to a brother, and then part of that word was about the end times. And so I copied and pasted that part of the word, and then I just prayed, and the Lord gave me some more about the end times and stuff. And it's pretty powerful, and I believe it's new information that I haven't heard being said. And I'm declaring right now in the name of Jesus, this is from the Lord. So what I'm telling you right now, you know, this attack, you know, this sudden attack, maybe it's on the United States. Because I'm an American, I would assume maybe it's the United States. I'm not sure if it's a literal attack on the United States, like what people are talking about. I know that destruction is coming to America. You know, when there are people talk about different ways of how that will happen, whether it's a Russian Chinese, whether it's a North Koreans, and I've been talking about this for a long time, and I just saw it was on the news today that the North Koreans, you know, have some submarine that they can shoot nuclear missiles from. I've been talking about that, you know, the North Koreans are shooting short-range nuclear missiles from a container ship out in the harbor. Well, you know, we have container ships coming from all over the world. They come into San Francisco Harbor, whatever, New York Harbor, whatever. They can shoot a rocket, and there's no way to stop it because it's just, whatever, 10 miles away or whatever it is. It's just a short-range thing, and nobody can really do anything about it as far as I know. Except for the Lord, of course. Anyhow, so this stand to is something the Lord's been telling me about. In other words, to be ready for the attack. You know, to be prepared for imminent attack in twilight, just as the sun is about to come up or go down. So anyway, brothers and sisters, I want to read this word that the Lord has given me. And like I said, the first part is a word I got last night for a brother. And I left out the part about the heavenly shades of night are falling. It's all interconnected. So now I want to read this to you. The hour is late. Hasten unto the day of the Lord, for it is a day of thick clouds and darkness. A lot of this stuff is Bible verses, brothers and sisters. Most of what the Lord will give you when you get a word from the Lord are Bible verses. Hasten unto the day of the Lord, for it is a day of thick clouds and darkness. It cometh upon the world, and they shall not escape. I must avenge mine enemies. I set destruction in the land of the Chaldeans, and in the land of the Jesuits, and in the land of the far north. Now, I was just thinking right now, when I wrote this, I was thinking about Rome. But the Lord just prompted me, as I'm reading it to you, brothers and sisters, today, right now, that the land of the Jesuits is actually on the border. Now, Sister Rosemary and Kelly and I talked about this when I was doing my research on the fleur-de-lis and all that. That Ignatius Loyola, he was born, and I've been talking about this, for the Antichrist to come from the border of France and Spain of royal bloodline. I've been talking about that for several years now in my videos over time. So the Lord is just prompting me, you know, that location is on the French-Spanish border area, the Basque region of Spain. Now, they're famous because they want to make an independent nation. And they talk about it all the time, the Basque region. So the land of the Jesuits is not Rome, as I thought myself, since I wrote this from the Lord's inspiration since yesterday. Now I'm saying right here that the Lord has prompted me, the land of the Jesuits is the Basque region between Spain and France. And, okay, I must avenge mine enemies. So I didn't say the United States in here as far as I know. I don't know. Listen, I set destruction in the land of the Chaldeans, and in the land of the Jesuits, and in the land of the far north. Now, in my opinion, the far north is Russia or whatever. I don't know. But, I mean, the United States is north, too, compared to Israel. So whenever people prophesy, and it's from the Lord, it's always from the reference point of Israel. Or it could be from the reference point of where the prophet is. But in the Bible, it was always, you know, countries around Israel and dealing with Israel. Of course, because they were Israeli people who were prophesying. But, you know, I'm an American. So it's possible, you know, from the position of America. But I'm in the Philippines now. Let's see, anyway. In the land of the north. I'm sorry I keep interrupting because I want to give the commentary as I'm going. I strike with my weapons and my bow. I knock down the self-righteous in their own delusions and the captives into outer darkness. So in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, we see the people are in the strong delusion that actually comes from the Lord. During the tribulation, I strike with my weapons and my bow. I knock down the self-righteous in their own delusions and captivities into outer darkness. Now, to me, it's just coming in my spirit. We're talking about this ISIS and stuff like that. For I am the Lord, and besides me, there is no other. I have consecrated the day and set it in motion. Even now. Listen to that. In the beginning, I said the hour is late. This is the word that I gave, part of the word I gave to our brother last night. Some of it was personal to him. This is the last part that I felt led by the Lord to share with you guys. The hour is late, okay? And at the end it says, I have consecrated the day and set it in motion. It's already in motion. Even now. All right, this is what I got today. Set the ramparts. Now, you have to look those things up. Divide the time. understand my seasons, set the ramparts. You're talking about setting up these, like, you know, ditches and what I was talking about, stand to and all that. You're talking about like foxholes and stuff. But, you know, a big thing, ramparts is like for a battle, for defense of a battle. You can look that up. Divide the time. And that means understand the time. Divide the time. Understand my seasons. Know that I am near even at the door. I pray that people can get that through their head. Know that I am near even at the door. Craft. Now, this is. Then the Lord started speaking to me about the Antichrist. It's pretty wild. I've never really got a word about the Antichrist too much. Know that I am near even at the door. Craft shall prosper in his hand. Now, that's a biblical reference directly to the Antichrist from Daniel. And destruction shall follow hard after him. Okay, I believe the book of Revelation, the first horseman on the white horse is the Antichrist. And the first seal, the second seal is war. The red horse is war. So I believe that's what the Lord is referring to in this sentence. Craft shall prosper in his hand, and destruction shall follow hard after him. Now, craft is like being crafty and deceitful and making a peace treaty. And I didn't think about it. These wording, this is one way you know it's from the Lord, because it's in a wording that I wouldn't use. As I look at it afterwards, I see the meaning is biblical. And destruction shall follow hard after him. He is a Chaldean and a liar, a deceiver of men. You hear that? The Antichrist. Now, I've never been a proponent of this doctrine. Perry Stone and those guys are the ones who usually say this. But I don't know if it literally means, I guess it does, a Chaldean, whatever. He is a Chaldean and a liar and a deceiver of men. He is a fornicator and a drunkard. He is lame in spirit and deaf in tongue. Now, I don't know what that means to be deaf in tongue. I've never even thought, and I tried to rewrite that. I prayed about it and asked the Lord to correct me. What is that? You know, that doesn't make any sense. And I spent several minutes praying about it. That's the text from the Lord. He is a fornicator and a drunkard. He is lame in spirit and deaf in tongue. His mantle is his mandate, and his whims are his ways. His mantle is his mandate, and his whims are his ways. Shock and fear are the foundations of his throne. I thought that was pretty cool and makes sense. He delights himself in a man and in the ways of a man. Okay, now I believe this is shifting, and just like Daniel too, but it's about what's going on. Social upheaval shall grow and grow until the end. Social upheaval shall grow and grow until the end. Ethnic group against ethnic group. You know, nation shall rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. For the number of his days, now I prayed about this line too. For the number of his days shall be 80. Now that's 80. But I don't know if it means 80 years. Or, you know, I kept seeing also when I prayed about this, I kept seeing an angel in a large number 8. For the number of his days shall be 80. Branded are his followers. And this is another sentence that I prayed over again and again, this next one, because it rhymes. And I thought, I said, is this, you know, right? Branded are his followers. It's the Antichrist. Tried and true and colored in blue are my words. Tried and true and colored in blue are my words. Now, the Lord explained to me when I prayed about this sentence, because it's like a rhyme. Blue is the color of revelation. You know, to get a revelation from God is blue, sapphire. Tried and true and colored in blue are my words. And then the Lord is just prompting me now. You know, I've given lots of you guys words of wisdom and word of knowledge. This is about me. This is what the Lord is saying about, you know, that I'm saying this. And that's what interpretation the Lord has given me for this sentence. Tried and true and colored in blue are my words. So I have lots of witnesses on here, dozens and dozens of people who I've given a word to, and that it's from the Lord, and they know that. So that's what the Lord is. Tried and true and colored in blue are my words. They are revelation from the Lord, words of wisdom, words of knowledge. That's the meaning of that sentence. Thank you, Lord, for saying that about me, through me. Thank you, Lord. Deception is at the gates. Deception is at the gates. Listen to this warning. Deception is at the gates, full of anger and abounding in lust. Deception is at the gates, full of anger and abounding in lust. Now, you can have lust for the flesh. You can have lust for the eyes. You can be covetous. You know, you can have lust, bloodlust. It's not only sexual lust, bloodlust. Like about all these riots, I believe the Lord's referring to about the social upheaval in the United States. We have pushing toward like a racial riots and stuff. But in other countries, look, the Sunni and the Shia and all these different groups are going after each other all over the world. The Middle East is all going on with the same thing. The Kurds and the whatever, all these different groups are fighting each other all over the world. Ethnic group against ethnic group. The ethnos against ethnos. Jesus said in the text, the Greek words for, you know, one ethnic group versus, you know, kingdom against kingdom, nation against nation. Deception is at the gates, full of anger and abounding in lust. Sound the alarm on my holy mountain. That's for all of us, like myself right now, and then all of you guys. Sound the alarm on my holy mountain. Incite my people from violence to prayer. See, so I love the way the Lord said that too. Praise God for inspiring me to write it that way, because inciting people to a riot, right? But the Lord says, incite my people from violence to prayer. Demonstrate my love to the masses and go in peace. That's the word from the Lord. And that's pretty cool. And I prayed for any more than that, like something like I come quickly again or something like that. The Lord said, no. That's it. Incite my people from violence to prayer. Demonstrate my love to the masses and go in peace. How about that? That's pretty cool. I'm going to read the whole thing again straight away. The hour is late. Hasten unto the day of the Lord, for it is a day of thick clouds and darkness. It cometh upon the world, and they shall not escape. I must avenge mine enemies. I set destruction in the land of the Chaldeans, and in the land of the Jesuits, and in the land of the far north. I strike with my weapons, with my bow. I knock down the self-righteous in their own delusions, and captives into outer darkness. For I am the Lord, and besides me there is no other. I have consecrated the day, and set it in motion, even now, even now. Set the ramparts, divide the time, understand my seasons. Know that I am near, even at the door. Craft shall prosper in his hand, and destruction shall follow hard after him. He is a Chaldean and a liar, a deceiver of men. He is a fornicator and a drunkard. He is lame in spirit and deaf in tongue. His mantle is his mandate, and his whims are his ways. Shock and fear are the foundations of his throne. He delights himself in a man and in the ways of a man. Social upheaval shall grow and grow until the end, for the number of his days shall be 70. Branded are his followers. Tried and true and colored in blue are my words. Deception is at the gate, full of anger and abounding in lust. Sound the alarm on my holy mountain. Incite my people from violence to prayer. Demonstrate my love to the masses and go in peace. Brothers and sisters, that's the word of the living God, and the Lord has prompted me to share this with you. And the Lord has been showing me so many other things, brothers and sisters. I don't even have time to make videos about them. And the Lord has shown me so many deep things. And I only share, you know, when I have time. But praise God, the Lord prompted me to share this. So God bless you all. Go in peace. Go in peace and show, what does it say here? Demonstrate my love to the masses and go in peace. Brothers and sisters, incite my people from violence to prayer. You know, you could be walking down the street when some of this, you know, hands up, don't shoot, and all this is going on. You know, it's the time to bring the love of Christ to bear. Bring the love of Christ to bear. Now, the Antichrist is going to try to be a hero and get all this stuff straightened out, all this ethnic group against ethnic group, and try to bring world peace. We know that. I mean, that's what the Bible says. He will come on a platform of peace. He will enter deceitfully. He is a man of deception and craft. He's crafty, and it will prosper in his hand. But this destruction will follow hard after him. The Bible already says that in different words. Brothers and sisters, it's almost time for us to get out of here. The hour is late. You need to pray up, pack up, look up, repent up, because we're going up. Be ready to go at a moment's notice. But while you're here, be ready to witness. While you're here, don't be queer. No, I'm sorry. While you're here, be ready to witness. But to the world, we are queer. The word queer meaning strange. To the world, we are strange, brothers and sisters. And we need to do that and be a witness, brothers and sisters. God bless you. God bless you all. You know that I love you all. May the peace of God be with you. I'll try to keep making videos before I leave to go to the States. I'm going to be busy preparing. And I have to, you know, I'm trying to set up now this fourth orphanage. Praise God. I'm going to be putting two children with James and May. May and James for the fourth orphanage. Put two kids with them. And I ask you to continue to pray for James, that he will follow through with what he promised. And about not drinking. And get right with the Lord. And you know, and repent and get straightened out with the Lord. And then for orphanage number 3, of course, as we started that, guys. I thank you for your prayers. And I'll be trying to make some more videos before I leave out of here beginning of next week. God bless.